Let us pray.
Ẹjẹ́ kí a gbàdúrà.
Our Father, we thank you for how you are blessing us. We thank you for a word that is coming to us by your Spirit.
Bàbá wa dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín fún ọ̀nà tí ẹ ti ń gbà bùkún wa àti fún àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ yín tí ó ń tọ̀wọ̀ wá nípasẹ̀ ẹ̀mí yín.
We thank you very much, O Lord, for your love for us.
A dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín gidigidi fún ìfẹ́ tẹ́ ẹ ní sí wa.
And that love makes you to speak very intimately to our hearts.
Ìfẹ́ yìí ló sì máa ń mú kí ẹ bá wa sọ̀rọ̀ bí tọmọ tìyá.
We know you are preparing us for the coming glory.
A mọ̀ pé ẹ pèsè wa sílẹ̀ dé lógo ni.
And we pray that your labor on us will not be in vain in Jesus' name.
A sì ń bẹ̀bẹ̀ pé kí gbogbo làálàá yín lórí wa kó má ṣe já sásán lórúkọ Jésù.
Love every one of us. And because you know what will hinder us from getting to heaven.
Send
your word to us so that we can be fully prepared. And we pray that none of us will reject your love or spurn your love or belittle your love in Jesus' name.
A sì ń gbàdúrà wípé kó má ṣe sí ẹni tí ó kọ ìfẹ́ yín tàbí tí ó kẹ́gàn ìfẹ́ yín tàbí tí ó fojú tẹ́ńbẹ́lú ìfẹ́ yín ní orúkọ Jésù.
We pray that we'll open our hearts to your word this morning.
À ń gbàdúrà wípé kí ẹ ṣe ọkàn wa payá fún ọ̀rọ̀ yín ní àárọ̀ yìí.
Help us to forget man and think about you.
Ẹ ràn wá lọ́wọ́ láti gbàgbé nípa ènìyàn ká sì máa ronú nípa yín.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ní orúkọ Jésù ni a gbàdúrà.
We thank the Lord for the progress we are making in our retreat.
A dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ Ọlọ́run fún ìtẹ̀síwájú tí a ní níbi ìpàgọ́ wa.
It's been a good time, a wonderful time with the Lord.
Ó ti jẹ́ àkókò tó dára, àkókò ìyanu pẹ̀lú Olúwa.
And you have seen how the Lord, step by step, had been blessing us.
Àwa náà sì ti rí bí Olúwa ti ń bùkún wa ní sísẹ̀ntẹ̀lé.
You have seen how he has been exposing to us his own way.
A ti rí bí ó ṣe ń fi ọ̀nà rẹ̀ hàn wá.
And what we want to talk about now is very essential, very important for all pilgrims journeying on to heaven.
Ohun tí ó sì wà fẹ́ bá wa sọ nísinsìnyí, ó ṣe pàtàkì, kò ṣe má ní ló jẹ́ fún gbogbo àwọn arìnrìn àjò tó lọ sí ìlú ọ̀run.
And as we approach the word of God, we approach the word of God with humility, with a heart to receive.
Bí a ti wá ń lọ sínú ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run, à ń súnmọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run pẹ̀lú ìrẹ̀lẹ̀ àti ọkàn láti rí gbà.
As we look at everything going on around us.
Bí a ṣe ń wo gbogbo àwọn nǹkan tó ń yí wa ká tó ṣẹlẹ̀.
We need to realize that we're getting near to the end of time.
Ó yẹ kó yeye wa wípé a ti ń súnmọ́ sí òpin ayé.
And at the end of time, there will be quite a lot of things happening.
Ní òpin ayé, oríṣiríṣi àwọn nǹkan ni ó sì máa ṣẹlẹ̀.
And it is then that a real child of God will take to heart what we see in Jeremiah chapter 6.
Ìgbà náà gan ló sì yẹ kí àwọn ọmọ Ọlọ́run kí wọ́n fi ọ̀rọ̀ tí a rí nínú Jeremiah orí kẹfà sínú ọkàn.
And in verse 16.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ 16.
Thus says the Lord, stand ye in the ways and see and ask for the old paths, where is the good way, and walk therein, and ye shall find rest for your souls.
Báyìí ni Olúwa wí, ẹ dúró ní ojú ọ̀nà kí ẹ sì wò, kí ẹ sì bèrè ojú ọ̀nà ìgbani, ewo ni ọ̀nà dídára, kí ẹ sì rìn níbẹ̀, ẹ̀yin ó sì rí ìsinmi fún ọkàn yín.
Here we are told that we need to stand still.
Níhìn ni a ti sọ fún pé a ń láti dúró.
A lot of people that jump before they see.
Àwọn ẹlòmíràn máa ń fò kó tó di pé wọ́n ò rí n tó ń ṣe.
They move before they think.
Wọ́n á ti máa lọ kí wọ́n tó ronú.
And they get to places without thinking of the consequence of what they are doing.
Wọ́n ti débi tí wọ́n lọ tán kí wọ́n tó ro nǹkan tó lè jẹ́ àṣẹ ìwà àṣẹ ìbọn
kan tó ń ṣe. And in the new day that is dawning now, and in the new time that we're living in now, a lot of modern things, a lot of new things will come up, and then we're about to forget the old thing and the old path that will take us to eternal rest.
Bí ilé ọjọ́ tó tó sì ṣe mọ́, tí ọjọ́ gorí ọjọ́, bẹ́ẹ̀sì ni a rí pé oríṣiríṣi àwọn àṣà ìgbàlódé ló ń dé tó jẹ́ pé wọ́n jẹ́ otitun titun tó fẹ́ máa mú wa gbàgbé àwọn nǹkan tàti
jẹ́. And the Lord is saying, stand ye in the ways and see, and ask for the old power.
Olúwa sì wá sọ wípé dúró ní ojú ọ̀nà kí ẹ sì wò kí ẹ sì bèrè ojú ọ̀nà ìgbaanì.
That old path is a good way.
Ojú ọ̀nà ìgbaanì ọ̀nà dídára ni.
And walk therein.
Kí ẹ sì máa rìn níbẹ̀.
Only then will you find rest for your soul.
Nígbà náà nìkan lẹ́tọ̀ rí ìsinmi fún ọkàn
yín. In Isaiah chapter 35.
Nínú Isaiah orí 15:8.
Reading from verse 8. And an highway shall be there, and a way, it shall be called the way of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for those the wayfaring men, though fools, shall not err therein.
Opopo kan yo si wa nibe ati ona kan as ma pe ni ona iwa mimo alaimo ki yo koja nibe nitori owo wa pelu won. Àwọn èrò ọ̀nà náà bí wọ́n tilẹ̀ jẹ́ òpè wọn kì yóò ṣí.
No lion shall be there, nor any ravenous beast shall go up thereon. It shall not be found there, but the redeemed of the Lord shall walk there.
Kìnní kì yóò sí níbẹ̀, bẹ́ẹ̀ ni ẹranko búburú kì yóò gùn, a kì yóò rí níbẹ̀, ṣùgbọ́n àwọn tí ara padà ni yóò máa rìn níbẹ̀.
This is talking about the way of holiness. And the word of God is telling us that that is the way redeemed of the Lord must walk. If
we're
going to get to that final place, we must search out the way of holiness and walk therein. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4.
Thessalonica kini ori kerin.
Reading from verse 7.
Awon kala ti ese ikeje.
For God has not called us unto uncleanness, but unto holiness.
Nitori Olorun ko pe wa fun iwa eri, sugbon ni iwa mimo.
He has not called us unto uncleanness.
Ko pe wa fun iwa eri.
To careless living.
Lati ma gbegbe aye ijafara.
To immoral living.
Igbe aye ti o to.
To inconsistent lifestyle.
Igbe aye sekuseye.
But he has called us unto holiness.
Sugbon ti pe wa si iwa mimo.
And that's why we're considering the word today, sanctification and the crucifixion of self.
Ìdí tó fi jẹ́ pé ọ̀rọ̀ tí a wá ń gbéyẹ̀wò lónìí ni ìsọdi mímọ́ àti kan ìfẹ́ ara ẹni nìkan máa
jẹ́ òbí. The topic is very important for everyone that wants to make heaven his home at last.
Kókó ọ̀rọ̀ ó ṣe pàtàkì fún gbogbo èèyàn tó bá fẹ́ fi ọ̀run ṣe ilé níkẹyìn.
The message of holiness is not a message you can put to the side.
Ìwàásù ìwà mímọ́ kìí ṣe ìwàásù tá a lè fọwọ́ tì sẹ́gbẹ́ kan.
If we're going to walk with the holy God.
Bí a bá fẹ́ bá Ọlọ́run mímọ́ rìn.
If we're going to get to that holy heaven.
Tí a bá fẹ́ dé ọ̀run mímọ́ ni.
If we're going to eventually be in the midst of the holy angels.
Bí a bá fẹ́ wà láàrin àwọn angẹ́lì mímọ́ nígbà ó ṣe.
If we're going to have fellowship with people like Enoch, people like Noah, people like Daniel, people like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, people like Paul, and people like Peter. If we're going to be with the redeemed of the Lord on the last day, holiness sanctification is not a subject we can put at the background.
Bí a bá fẹ́ wà pẹ̀lú àwọn èèyàn bíi Enoch, pẹ̀lú àwọn èèyàn bíi Noah, pẹ̀lú àwọn èèyàn bíi Daniel, pẹ̀lú àwọn èèyàn bíi Shadrach, Meshach àti Abednego, àti àwọn èèyàn mímọ́ wọn ni, a ò ní fi ọwọ́ rọ ọ̀rọ̀ ìwà mímọ́ sẹ́yìn.
The words in the message, the words are very important.
Àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ tí ń bẹ nínú ìwàásù ó jẹ́ àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ tó ṣe
kókó. There is a word sanctification.
Ọ̀rọ̀ kan ń bẹ tí a pè ní ìsọdí.
There is the word crucifixion.
Ìkọ́síwà tí a pè ní ìkànmọ́.
And there is the word self.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ sì ni ẹran ara ń bẹ.
Actually, self is the most pronounced thing in the life of every human being.
Ẹran ara ó sì jẹ́ èyí tí a máa ń sábà mẹ́nu bà nínú ìgbé ayé gbogbo ènìyàn.
The self is the center of the life of man that sits upon the throne wanting to control that man's life.
Ẹran ara ó ló máa ń já dúró tó máa ń gún wà nínú ọkàn ènìyàn láti máa dá ṣe àkóso ara rẹ̀.
It is self that holds the key.
Ẹran ara ló mú kọ́kọ́rọ́ lọ́wọ́.
That tells everyone, keep your distance, don't come in here, I control here, I am the master here, I am the controlling force in the life of that man. It is self that holds the key to the life of a man and will not even allow Christ to take control.
Tó máa sọ fún ènìyàn wípé, mọ̀ wọ́n ara rẹ̀. ma re koja si yi emi ni mo sakoso bi emi ni mo wa ni bi ni yi olomo nfe lati je pe ko so pe o n lo je esu to sakoso ara.
It is self that puts the man on the throne. That would even like to compete with God. That when God talks, he says, keep quiet, I'm here also, I want to talk. It is self that hinders a man from surrendering to Christ. It is self that says there's no need of any other master, I'm master here. It is self that tells a man, you must not bend, you must not yield, you must not submit, stand firm and confirm and assert the I in the life of man. It is self that needs to be dealt with. Because self will not inherit eternal life. Because self is related to the devil. Because it was self that made the devil to say, I will arise to the stars of heaven. I will exalt my throne above the throne of God. I will be like the Almighty. It is the I, the self in Satan that made him to be driven away from heaven.
Afemi, afemi, togbe esuwo. Tofi zo pe emi o gbe ite mi ga, emi o gbe ga koja ti Olorun, emi ma wo ni sale, afemi afemi titi to fi jabole, ohun na ni nkan to ma mu yan gori ite fura re.
And then that self needs to be dealt with.
Era re si je ta gbodo koju ja.
There needs to be a crucifixion.
Ikan ma gbele bu re gbodo
wa. So that you'll be able to say, I am crucified with Christ.
Ka wa le fo so ya pe ati kan mi ma
gbe. Nevertheless I live.
Sugbon mo wa laye.
And yet not I.
Ki se mi mo.
For the life I now live in the flesh. I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and died for me. You need to realize that the old man must be crucified. That the body of sin might be destroyed. That henceforth we should not serve sin. And that except the corn of which shall fall into the ground and die.
Ati pe ti ko ba so pe won wa le ka ma ba bole to si ku.
It abideth alone.
O wa o ne
ka. When it falls to the ground.
Sugbon nigba to ba so
pe mo ti le. When it dies.
To ba si ku.
When the self life is crucified.
Nigba ti gbogbo iwa
ati ba. Then it will bring forth good fruit.
Yo wa so so jade.
And then there is sanctification.
Isadi mana si wa.
When we talk of sanctify.
Nigba ti ba so nipa sadi
mana. Actually sanctify has connection with separate. S and S, sanctify, separate.
So the mima, yasoto.
Now that means then, first of all, you are separated from something. And something is separated from you. And then you now, a new person, is separated entirely unto God. Sanctification, separation. You are separated from sin. Sin is separated from you. Every form of sin, external sin, inward sin, secret sin, open sin, the little sin, the sin in the thought and in the mind, the sin in the very nature, your heart is circumcised. Nothing is extracted from you. The root of sin, it is uprooted. It is taken away. You no more possess it. It is separated from you. And you are separated from the sin. And then you now, a new person with a new nature, with a new heart, totally separated from every form of sin, you are now separated unto God. Separated unto God. To live only for God's glory. To speak only the word of God. To walk only in the way of the Lord. To exalt only the Lord. Sin is no more there. Self is no more there. And self is not controlling the throne of your heart anymore. And you are fully surrendered unto God now. Absolutely consecrated, dedicated to the Lord. Completely, eternally separated unto the Lord. The Lord belongs to you. You belong to the Lord. You are sanctified. That is the will of God. There is no doubt about it. That the Lord himself said, that is his will. He wants everyone to be so separated from sin, so separated unto the Lord. You are only to live for the glory of God for the rest of your life. All that to happen, we're going to consider it systematically, and we're going to consider it thoroughly in the Word of God. Three things we're going to consider. Number one, conversion of the sinner. The conversion of the sinner. Number two, crucifixion of self. The crucifixion of self. Number three, consecration for sanctification. Consecration for sanctification. It is very important that we need to know that we need conversion. Why do we need conversion? What is conversion? How does conversion take place? What is the evidence that conversion has taken place in my life or in your life? Why do we need conversion? Understand, conversion is a change. When you convert something, you change that thing. For example, when you convert a particular piece of iron to another kind of instrument, there is a change. There is a process that has taken place. Now there is a change and there is a conversion, and the use of that thing becomes different. That's conversion.
Fun apere yo da bi gba ti alagbede ba na mu irin kan to si fi ran kankan kan bi ada tabi kan miran a ri pe o ti pa irin ni da si kan miran be gan ni yi pada se ri.
Also, when you have paper and
the
paper is useless, but you have a lot of them, and therefore you take them to the converters, the people that will take those raw papers and put them into a kind of machine, run it out again and produce another kind of paper that is now useful. Conversion has taken place. When you find a useless man, a worthless man, not good for anything, not good for the kingdom of God, it's not good to even live life here, it's not good enough to even raise a good family here, it's a good for nothing man. And then you take that man, you put him in the hands of God, and he changes him, and he turns him over, and he cleanses his life, and he puts a purpose for living in his life. His head becomes correct, his mind functions normally, he now knows good from bad, he knows the right way from the evil way, because he's no more in crime, he's no more doing anything that is unreasonable and foolish. That
ordinary man.
Good for nothing man.
Ẹni tí òwúlò fún
kò
dákẹ́ lẹ̀.
Has been changed to become good for God.
Ó ti wá dé ta yí padà láti di ẹni
rere fún Ọlọ́run.
Ó dára fún ìjọba Ọlọ́run.
Good for heaven.
Ó dára fún ọ̀run.
A candidate of hell before.
Ẹni tó ti yẹ fún ọ̀run
àgbà ìtẹ́lẹ̀. On the way to perdition and destruction.
Ó ti wà lọ́nà ẹgbẹ́
àti ìkọ́tẹ́lẹ̀. The grace of God.
Orí ọ̀fẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
The power of the cross.
Agbára
àgbẹ̀lẹ̀lú.
The blood of Jesus.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù.
Ó wá mú ọkùnrin.
Turning that man around.
Ó yí ọkùnrin náà
padà. Changing his life.
Ó yí ìgbé ayé
padà. Putting him in the narrow way.
Ó wá fi sọ́jọ́
ọ̀nà tó rẹ̀. And he's now on his way to heaven.
Ó wá wà lójú ọ̀nà rẹ̀
láti gbọ́ ọ̀nà rẹ̀. And he's singing the song of heaven, amazing grace.
Ó sì wá kọ orin ọ̀run
tó rí ọ̀fẹ́. The change that came to my life.
Ìyípadà ọkàn tó ṣẹlẹ̀
lọ́wọ́. Once I was blind.
Nígbà tó mo fọ́jú.
But now I can see.
Ṣùgbọ́n mo lè rí
ọ̀rọ̀ báyìí. Once I was good for nothing.
Nígbà tó wọ òwúlò.
Now I am good. I'm a candidate of God, a candidate of heaven.
Mo ti jẹ ní rere, mo ti jẹ fún ọ̀run, mo ti jẹ fún ìjọba Ọlọ́run.
Conversion.
Ètí àpẹ ní ìyípadà
jọ ni yẹn. Transformation.
Ìyí sọ́dọ̀ tún.
A change has taken place.
Ìyípadà kan ti ṣẹlẹ̀.
A turning around has taken place.
Ìpadà kan ti ṣẹlẹ̀.
That is what is called conversion in the word of God.
Ètí àpẹ ní ìyípadà nínú ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ni yẹn.
I hope you pay attention to the word of God.
Mo lérò pé ó máa fetí sí ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
And you don't do any other thing while the message of the word of God is going on.
Ẹ̀sìn ni máa mú nǹkan míì ṣe nígbà tí ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run bá ń lọ lọ́wọ́.
It insults me when I'm preaching and I see people removing their fingernails while I'm praying in front of me, or picking something in their chin, or doing something, just doing some other things to distract their attention, not understanding that the word of God is a thing that takes you to heaven. If you don't want to listen to the word of God, don't sit in front of me, get out there and go to the back.
Ó máa ń jọ mí lójú nígbà tí mo bá rí pé ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run lọ lọ́wọ́ báyìí. Táwọn kan wá ń rè kan náà wọn tàbí tí a fọwọ́ já àgbọ̀n tàbí tí a ṣàṣe nǹkan kan tí ènìyàn láárí tó dàbẹ́ pé wọ́n fẹ́ máa fa ọkàn níwàásù lọ́sọ̀tọ̀ tàbí sósì.
Conversion is a change of life.
Ìyípadà ọkàn ni
kókó ìgbé ayé yìí padà. Awúrò takes a good for nothing man.
Nígbà tí a bá sì wá mú ẹni tí
òun yóò yìí. A man that didn't know right from left.
Ẹ tí ò mọ ọ̀tún yàtọ̀ sósì.
And it takes that man now and that man is in the narrow way that leads to heaven.
Tó sì wá mú báyìí tó ti wá fi ọkùnrin lé
I'm a converted man. I'm a transformed man. I have the grace of God in my life. That is conversion.
Tó wá sọ pé àwọn nǹkan tí mo ti ń ṣe tẹ́lẹ̀ rí n kò ní ṣe wọ́n mọ́. Mo ti di ẹni ọ̀tún. Mo ti ní ìyípadà ọkàn. Mo ti ní ẹ̀dá ọ̀tún. Mo sì mọ ibi tí mo lọ nísinsìnyí. Ìyẹn gan ni ìyípadà.
In Psalm 51.
Nínú orin Dáfídì kọkànléláàádọ́ta.
Psalm 51, we're reading there from verse 13.
Orin kọkànléláàádọ́ta àọ́kà láti ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlá.
Then I will teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee.
Nígbà náà ni èmi máa kọ́ àwọn olùrẹ́ kọjá ní ọ̀nà rẹ. Àwọn ẹlẹ́ṣẹ̀ yóò sì máa yí padà sí
ọ. You see conversion there.
Ẹ̀yin náà rí ìyípadà ní.
That sinners are converted unto the Lord.
Pé àwọn ẹlẹ́ṣẹ̀ yí padà sí Olúwa.
Now there are three things we're going to look at in conversion.
Àwọn nǹkan mẹ́ta la máa wò ní ìyípadà.
How it takes place.
Bí ó ti ń ṣẹlẹ̀.
What man does.
Ìtí ènìyàn ṣe.
What God does.
Ohun tí Ọlọ́run ṣe.
And what is the result of that cooperation between man and God.
Kí sì ló jẹ́ àbájáde ìfọwọ́sowọ́pọ̀ láàrin ènìyàn àti Ọlọ́run yìí?
Number one, confession.
Àkọ́kọ́ ìjẹ́wọ́.
Number two, cancellation.
Èkejì ìfagilé.
Number three, conscience.
Ìkẹta ẹ̀rí ọkàn.
Number one, confession of known sins.
Àkọ́kọ́ ni jíjẹ́wọ́ àwọn ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ tó mọ̀.
Number two, cancellation of confessed sins.
Èkejì ni fífagilé tàbí mímú àwọn ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ tí a
jẹ́ pé. Number three, conscience of the truly saved.
Ìkẹta ni ẹ̀rí ọkàn àwọn tó bẹ ní ìgbàlà ní tòótọ́.
You see, if we're going to have conversion, there must be confession of every known sin.
Ẹ̀rí tí a bá ní ìyípadà ọkàn, ìjẹ́wọ́ gbogbo ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ tá a ti dá ta mọ̀
yóò wà. Proverbs chapter 28 and verse 13.
Nínú ìwé òwe orí kejìdínlọ́gbọ̀n ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlá.
Proverbs 28 verse 13.
Òwe orí kẹta kẹ́kọ̀ọ́kan. Orí kejìdínlọ́gbọ̀n ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlá.
He that covereth his sin shall not prosper, but whoso confesseth and forsaketh them shall have mercy.
Ẹni tí ó bu ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ rẹ̀ mọ́lẹ̀ kì yóò ṣe rere,
That's the first step you have to take. You confess all the sins you know in your life. You won't hide anything. You will not cover anything. Everything that is evil, everything that is of darkness, everything related to immorality, everything that is against the word of God, everything that is contrary to the righteous law of the Lord, you will confess everything unto the Lord, so that the Lord will take everything away. In Luke chapter 18 verse 13, the publican standing afar off will not lift up so much as his eyes unto heaven, but is smote upon his breast, saying, God, be merciful unto me, a sinner. When you do that sincerely, you confess your sins to the Lord sincerely, you forsake them, you turn away from them, you hate them, you even hate yourself for having done such a thing, it becomes so serious in your heart, you even cry, you are sorrowful, you are sad because of the sins you have committed, you turn to the Lord with your whole heart.
And
you say, Lord, be merciful unto me, a sinner. That's a confession on your own part. There is the cancellation of that sin in the sight of God. Hebrews chapter 8 and verse 12. I will be merciful to the unrighteous, and their sins and their iniquities will I remember no more.
It
consumes them. He forgets them. He doesn't remember them again. He doesn't think of you as a sinner anymore. All the sins he has forgiven, he has also forgotten. He puts them in the sea of his forgetfulness. Because your sins are taken away. And then you become happy. You heard from the choir this time that they were singing, not this morning, but yesterday. You ask me why I'm happy, so I'll tell you why. Because my sins are gone. Where are they? They are under the sea of God's forgetfulness, never to be remembered against me anymore. In Micah chapter 7 verse 18. Who is a God like unto thee that pardoneth iniquity and passeth by transgression of the remnant of his heritage? He retaineth not his anger forever. Because he delighteth in mercy, he will turn again. He will have compassion upon us. He will subdue our iniquities. He will cast all their sins into the depths of the sea.
Tanya Lord be what on deji. Tell you ni rekoja, ko dai binu re duro titi lae, nitori oni no dinu si anu, yo yi pada, yo ni yanu siwa, yo si te asede de waba, iwo si sokbo bo eshe wa si mu agmu oku.
That's what the Lord does when you are forgiven. It is part of the conversion. You have confessed. God has forgiven you. He has cancelled all those confessing. You believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you are saved. Now, number 3, the conscience of a truly saved person.
Bayi iketa eri okan ni ti o ti je ni ibala ni
to ta. Maybe you told things before.
Boyo ti je awon kankan tele.
And like you heard during the question time yesterday.
Gege bo se be ni akoko ibe
lana. Somebody saying that before I came over here.
Eni ka so pe kin to wa
ti. There was an instrument for my company.
Irinse kan wa ti mo jin bi se wa.
And I've been using that instrument.
Mo ti lo irinse fura mi.
But I gave my life to the Lord on the first night.
Sugbon lale akoko ti mo de mo faye mi fun Oluwa.
And since that first night now.
Ati pe lata
le je lati pe my conscience is witnessing against me.
Le ri okan ti je ni pe ti mo se
da. I don't know what I'm going to do.
Mi wa mo gan ti mo fa se.
Because now my conscience will not allow me to use that thing again.
Nitori pe eri okan mi o fe faye gba mi lati ma lo nkan
yi. You remember the leader that helped us yesterday with the questions? Turn to Acts chapter 24 and verse 16.
Esi mo wi pe ele ranti pe e to dari wa lati da ibere lana o ti Bibeli esi ni wesa apostle
ri kan ni o so the truth for the word of God.
O ran wa leti otito ran Olorun
that when you are born again.
Ni tan gba ti o ba de ni
when you are truly converted.
Tan gba to ba ni yi pada kan
to all the stolen things that were stolen before.
Pe gbogbo awon kan to ti ji tele.
You will not be hiding them anymore.
O to ni ma fi won pa mo mo.
It's like what happened last week here.
O da bi kan to sele lose to koja ni.
A woman came to the retreat.
Obirin kan wa si ipago.
And then when we give testimony.
Nigba ti o sin jeri.
She came out to give testimony.
O na jade wa jeri.
She said she came to the first retreat.
O ni o wa si bi ipago akoko.
When she came to the first retreat.
Nigba to wa si bi ipago akoko.
She said she was just a sinner.
O ni elese paraku lo
je. And then in Joseph she took dress.
O ni ni bi tan so si o ko aso
aso. And she stole the dress.
O si je awo aso na lo.
And then the first retreat finished and ended.
Ipago akoko wa pari.
She went back home.
O pada lo sile.
She couldn't come to the second retreat to come and steal some more clothes.
Ko le wa si ipago elekeji lati tun wa ji aso mi.
Because she was sick.
Tori pe ara re ya.
But now she came to the third retreat.
O wa wa si ipago eleketa
bayi. Wanting to practice the old game again.
O to fe se bi o ti se tele.
And while the prayer was going on.
Nigba ti adura n lo lowo.
The clothes she was wearing at that time.
Aso to wo lowo ngba
lo. Was the clothes she stole in the first retreat.
Aso to ji ni bi ipago akoko ni.
And then that cloth was burning her like fire.
Aso ye wa jo ni ara bi ina.
The shoe she wore, it was stolen.
Bàtà tó wọ̀ ó jí
ni. The headgear she had, it was stolen.
Fi àgẹ̀lẹ̀ tó wẹ́ ó jí ni.
The dress she wore, everything up and down, it was stolen.
Gbogbo aṣọ tó wọ̀ látòkèdélẹ̀ ó jí ni.
And everything was burning her like fire.
Gbogbo ẹ̀ wá dàbí iná tó wú o.
And people just praying for the people to deliver and to heal. There was no deliverance, there was no healing, it was fire upon her.
Nígbà táwọn sì ń gbàdúrà fún ìdáǹdè àti ìwòsàn, kò sí ìwòsàn tàbí ìdáǹdè fún iná ló ń jó.
Then she said, "Oh Lord, I surrender."
Ni Oluwa mo fi gbogbo
ene. Praise the Lord.
Eyin Oluwa logo.
I said praise the Lord.
O ni eyin Oluwa logo.
She said, "Oh Lord, I surrender."
O ni Oluwa mo ti
ba. No more stealing.
Mo ni jale
ha. No more evil.
Mo ni se
ti. No more sin.
Mo ni dese
mo. Our God is a good God.
Olorun wa Olorun
re. Who is a God like unto thee?
Ta lo tun dabi
wa Olorun. That passeth iniquity.
To fi ese
ji. And will subdue our sins.
So si
ji ko se wa. In the depths of the sea.
Ti ogun oko.
And the Lord forgave her.
Oluwa si dariji.
And then the fire on her body everything went away. The fire burning her in the head because of the stolen egg here, everything went away. And then we said, now if God has done something for you, come out. And she came to hall 7. And then she was given chance to talk. And she confessed to the thousands of people here that as I am standing here, this nice dress you see that I'm wearing.
Aṣọ tẹ ri tó gúré gẹ lọ́rùn
mi ti mọ wọ̀nyí. The nice shoe you see that I'm wearing.
Bàtà tó ń dọ́ tẹ ri ti mọ wọ̀nyí.
This nice thing I used to cover my head and I look like a Christian.
Gé ìgèlè tẹ ri ti mọ wẹ́ ti mo dàbí Kírísítẹ́nì
tó wọ́ra yìí. I stole everything in the first retreat.
Gbogbo rẹ̀ ibi ìpàgọ́ àkọ́kọ́ tẹ ṣe ní
ìlò títí. But he said, now God has forgiven me.
Ṣùgbọ́n wá ní ní ìsìn Olúwa ti
gbá rí kìnnì. And when she said that, those the people that were here, they rejoiced. They too, they forgave her.
nigba to wa so awon to wa bi inu won do awon na dariji.
And her conscience became clear.
Eri oka re wa mo.
Because now she has told everybody.
Nitori mi nsin o ti so fun gbogbo
eyan. And she was ready to remove the thing and find the owner if she can and just give it back to the owner.
O ti wa so te lati bo gbogbo re ko fi fun oni nkan bo ba je pe le ri.
Praise God for retreat.
Eyin Oluwa Ologun fi ipa.
Praise God for retreat.
Eyin Oluwa Ologun fi ipa go.
Where lives are changing.
Nibi ti gbe aye
eyan ti ipa. Transformed. Where true conversion is taking place. And when true conversion takes place in your life, you are going to make restitution so that you have a conscience void of offense toward God and toward man.
Acts
chapter 24 verse 16.
And
do I exercise myself to have all ways a conscience void of offense toward God and toward man. Now, after that conversion has taken place, that's the beginning of the journey, not the end of the journey. It is the beginning of the Christian life, it is not the end of the Christian life. It is a commencement, it is not the climax or the consummation of the Christian life. Something still needs to happen that leads us now to point number two. It's the crucifixion of self. We're talking to believers now. You are born again, you are converted, there is a change, there is a transformation. You have now been given to the Lord. You have surrendered yourself to the Lord. There is still something inside, and that thing inside is ugly, and it is terrible, and it is dirty, and it will rear up its ugly head once in a while if you don't deal with that thing. If you don't get that thing crucified, if you don't subdue that thing, if you don't give that thing a deadly blow, if the thunder of the power of God from the throne of God does not strike that thing dead,
be ara
it's going to turn your life to look like a life as if you were not even born again. That thing will rear up its ugly head again. And eventually you might even become worse than what you were before. That thing can even make you to lose that salvation you are rejoicing in. It can make you a double fold child of hell even after you were saved. It can make you to return back into Egypt, and not just get back to Egypt ordinarily, but live in the worst part, in the slum area of Egypt when you go back to Egypt. That thing is called self.
In
Galatians chapter 2 verse 20, I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me, and the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me.
Ati kami ma agbelebu pelu Kristi sugbon mo wa laye sibe ki se mi mo sugbon Kristi wa laye ninu mi niwa ti mo si wa laye ninu ara That's
a crucifixion of self. Romans chapter 6. Reading from verse 6. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him.
And
see it in the scripture directly. It our old man, the one that controlled our old life, the master of our old life. It says the principle that was working in us before we knew the Lord. The old self, as old as a fall of man. This is the very nature of Satan.
Satan
is as ugly as Satan. Self is as rebellious as Satan. Self is as dirty as Satan. That's our old man, that self-life is crucified with him. That the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. Now, as we talk about the crucifixion of self, there are three things also to consider. Number one, the crushing of the self-life. The crushing of the self-life.
Number two,
cross-bearing in everyday life. Cross-bearing in everyday life. Number three, captivity to the Lord. Captivity to the Lord. We talk about crushing the self-life. How does self-manifest itself? Brothers and sisters, here is where we need to learn something. And by the grace of God, I've been a Christian now quite for some time. And from the earliest days of my Christian life, I've watched many people. I've seen many people. And I've seen the people that thought that they were real Christians and they were moving on in the Lord. And what they didn't realize, which I wanted every one of us to realize, is that a person may have success if self is underneath that success, is going to ruin his Christian life. A person may have might if self is underneath that might, is going to make a shipwreck of his faith. Let me show you in the Bible. In Genesis chapter 11.
Genesis,
reading from verse 1. These people, they wanted to make a great tower. Look at it in verse 4. And they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. Let us make a name. The pursuit of fame and popularity. Do you know that underneath it is self?
Do
you know it is possible to have that kind of success and not be sanctified?
Do you
know it is possible to build a high tower whose top may reach unto heaven and not be sanctified? And then even God said in verse 6, the Lord said, behold, the people is one. Cooperation and unity without sanctification. That cooperation is because the pride that was leading them, the pride that was guiding them, they wanted to build this strong tower, and because of the same pride in all their hearts, there was uniformity, there was togetherness, there was cooperation, there was a kind of unity among them. Success will not take anyone to heaven.
And
success will not take any preacher to heaven.
It
is sanctification, holiness that takes us to heaven, not success. It is not progress. It is not ability. It is not administration.
To
have ability, to have good administration, the people are cooperating under me, well, maybe self is still there.
The thing
you are rejoicing in is the thing that will destroy you. You see, when I look at a congregation like this, it never comes to my mind that I'm a pastor of a large church, because I know that being a pastor of a large church never takes anybody to heaven. Moses was a pastor of 3 million people. He didn't get to the land of Canaan. There's nobody that has a church now as large as the congregation of Moses in the wilderness. And there is no miracle worker now that is bringing water out of the rock. No pastor now, a church founder that is building his congregation with manna from heaven for 40 years.
What is he? You does not joke. That is so good.
There is no pastor now that God is disciplining his members for him and said, if they will leave them alone, the earth will open, they will get inside.
That message
was successful.
Moses,
we're talking about getting to Canaan.
You
remember what he had, Moses?
So
that self-life we're talking about. He came to the congregation. And he said, you rebels.
He's
weeping water out of the rock for you. He was not the one that was bringing the water for them out of the rock.
And
there was a rod in his hand. And he struck that rock.
That's why.
Did water come out? Did water come out?
Water
came out. Miracle happened.
I'm
telling you that miracle working will not take me or take you to heaven. It is the cancellation and the crushing and the destruction of the
self-life.
After the water come out from the
wrong,
3 million people drank water.
I
said, Moses, come here. We need to talk. I see that ugly thing inside you.
No,
that self-life inside you.
I
forgot to yourself that you were Tamara. You were nothing. And I made you to become a leader. See what you have done. Okay, get to the mountain. See that. You see how you are near to the land of promise. You will not get there. You will die here. I will bury you myself.
So, what is that, Benny? So, anybody want to know what I come here, Lord. Many things. Why are you going to be okay?
wọ́lẹ̀ lórí náà lọ́ọ̀kan ò ní débẹ̀ ibi ìlú òkú sí wọ́n sì sin ọ́fà mi.
And it is when that is the same we can get to the land of Canaan.
Nígbà tó bá pa àfẹ́mí àfẹ́mí rẹ̀ nìkan lọ pẹ́lẹ́dẹ̀ lọ kí náà nì.
Before Samuel 15, second Samuel rather, chapter 15.
Lọ́lẹ̀ nìkan jẹ́rìkẹ̀ẹ́dógún.
Here we see another fellow manifesting self. Look at you from verse 4. Absalom said, moreover, that I will make the judge in the land, that every man which has any suit of cause might come unto me, and I will do him justice.
Absalom said, abájọ́ tí mi ṣe onídàájọ́ nílẹ̀ yìí kí olúkúlùkù ẹni tẹ́ ní ẹjọ́ tábí ọ̀rọ̀ kan balẹ̀ máa tọ́ mi wá èémi ìbáàdì ṣe ìgbádùn òtítọ́ fún un.
You see the problem was solved, it distressed the man in which it is.
Ṣé rí bá ewu ìṣòro tó wà pẹ̀lú àtẹ̀mí Adami ó gbá ọba ìdí ayé àtọ̀rọ̀
jẹ́. Solomon was the son of a king. What else was he looking for?
Ọ̀nà ọba lọ́wọ́ Sàlómù jẹ́ ìkíni tó ń wà kiri.
He had committed terrible sin before. He even ran away. He was brought back. After that forgiveness, what else was he looking for?
Ó ti bẹ́ẹ̀ ṣe tó burú jẹ ìtẹ́lẹ̀ tó jẹ́ pé tiẹ̀ sá lọ.
What he had done in orchestrating and plotting and planning the death of one of the king's son was a terrible thing. He should have died. He should have been killed. He wasn't killed. Nancy was given unto him. He was even brought back near the king. What else was he looking for?
Bí o fi ṣe gbọ́dọ̀ àwọ̀gán tó ṣe síbẹ̀síbẹ̀ àtúnmọ̀padà wá àfà náà fún kí ni tó tún wá kiri.
Self will never say thank you.
Ẹsẹ̀ ọ̀rẹ́ nìkan kò ní jẹ́ kí èyí ló
bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí. Self will never appreciate any good thing you do for them.
Ìfẹ́ ọ̀rẹ́ ní kò ní jẹ́ kó wọ́n máa rírí ogún tó bá ṣe
fún ẹ. Give them forgiveness, it's not enough.
Fún ọ̀nà ìdáríjì kò lẹ́tọ̀
wọn. Allow them to be in the palace, it's not enough.
Ìwọ́n sí ààfin kò lẹ́tọ̀ wọn.
Allow them to have opportunity, it's not enough.
Wọ́n ti wọ́n lọ́ọ̀tà nìkan kò lẹ́tọ̀ wọn.
Self is never satisfied.
Ẹ̀fẹ́ ọ̀rẹ́ nìkan kì í ní
tẹ́lẹ̀. It's like a basket where you are pouring water, it is never full.
Ó dàbí àpẹẹrẹ tí wọ́n ń pọn méjì ni kò lẹ́kún láéláé.
So Absalom came and he said, oh, that I, this myself, will make the judge in the land.
Absalom wa dìde wa sọ pé èmi àbájá fi èmi kíni gan ṣe onídàájọ́ nílẹ̀ yìí.
And it was so that when any man came nigh unto him to do him what he sons to respect him as the son of a king, he put forth his hand and he took him and he kissed him. On this manner did Absalom to all Israel that came to the king for judgment for counseling. So Absalom stole the hearts of the men of Israel.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni bí ẹnìkan bá sì sọmọ láti tẹ̀rí bá fún un láti bọ́ lọ fún tí wọ́n bọ̀wọ̀ fún gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọmọ ọba òun láti náwó rẹ̀ àwọn sì dì í mú láti fi ẹnu kò ní ẹnu. Irú ìwà báyìí ni Absalom amáhùn sí gbogbo Israẹli tí ó fà bá wá nítorí ìdájọ́. Absalom sì fa ọkàn àwọn ènìyàn Israẹli sábọ́ rẹ̀.
Can you see diplomacy here?
Sẹ́ẹ̀rì wà yìí ni gẹ́gẹ́ bí.
Self was under that diplomacy.
Ìwé rárá ló wà lábẹ́ àràbà
yìí. Can you see a kind of humility here?
Nígbà rí kájọjọ ẹ̀rẹ̀ lẹ́yìn.
When anybody wanted to bow down, you get up, we are equal. What I'm saying is that if I am made a judge, a leader over everyone, I will do good to everybody. And everybody began to talk, saying, do you see how humble Absalom is? Under that humility, there was self.
Nígbà tí àwọn ẹ̀yìn bá sì wà tá àtẹ́rí bá fún a ní àdídé ìkẹ̀kẹ́ náà níwájú láti jura wa lá. Nítorí ẹ̀ máa wulẹ̀ bí òkìtà láti gbọ́ àtẹ́rí bá. Àwọn ẹgbẹ́ náà wà àbẹ́ẹ̀rí ó ti di ọmọ ọba ìwò bó ṣe ní ìrẹ̀lẹ̀ tó lábẹ́ ìrẹ̀lẹ̀ tó sápò ní òótọ́ wà ní pé kó gbé ipò ńlá kan.
It was the self that destroyed him. He died before his time. And what kind of death did he die?
Ìfẹ́ ara ẹ̀ran ara mi nìkan òní tó parun irú ikú wọlé sì kú.
In Daniel chapter 4.
Nínú Dánielì orí kẹrin.
Reading from verse 3.
Láti ẹsẹ̀ ọgbọ̀n.
And the king spake and said, is not this great Babylon that I have built for the house of the kingdom by the might of my power and for the honor of my majesty?
Ọba sì dáhùn, orí pé kò ṣe pé èyí ni Bábélì ńlá tí èmi ti fi nílé agbára mi kọ́ ní ilé ìjọba àti fún ògo ọ̀la ńlá mi.
Can you see the bragging and the boasting here?
Ṣé iná rí ìfọ́nú àti ìyangàn
yìí? It is pride that makes us to boast.
Ìgbéraga ló máa mú ní sọ́lọ̀.
You find a person that is so-called a Christian bragging and boasting.
Nígbà tó bá rí ọ ní pẹ̀lú rẹ̀ Christian ìbẹ̀rẹ̀ tẹ̀sán ló fọ́ ló tó ń ṣògo.
This great Babylon.
Babylonian lie
that I have built for the house of the kingdom by the might of my power, for the honor of my majesty. What happened to him? It was self that drove him from the throne, from the palace, and drove him to the forest for 7 seasons to pass over him. In Acts chapter 12, from verse 20, and Herod was highly displeased with them of Tyre and Sidon. But they came with one accord to him, and having made blasters, the king's chamberlain, their friend, and desired peace because their country was nourished by the king's country.
Hello, do you see Bino Gibigidi? See, I want to see them,
In verse 21, and upon his said day, Herod arrayed in royal apparel, sat upon his throne, and made an oration unto them. When he said he made an oration, that's a public kind of presentation, like a kind of a public scene, a political thing. He spoke, he moved their heart. And the people gave a shout, saying, "It is the voice of a God and not the voice of a man." And immediately the angel of the Lord smote him, because he gave not the glory to God. And he was eating of worms, and he gave up the ghost. Can you see where self led him? People who say they are born again, the self has not been crucified. Self has not been crushed. As they interact and relate with other people, you can see that self. Even if they are illiterate or poor people, they look at the whole world as if the whole world is nothing, and they are the king on his
own.
They will not allow us to rest. Just like they are the king of the whole world. And see this one here, he made an oration, he made a public declaration, and everybody said, "This man is not ordinary man, he is a God." He didn't say he was God. Other people said he is a God, and he accepted that false honor and praise. Said, "Yes, you recognize how high I am." Immediately an angel of God came from heaven. He is competing with Almighty God, smote him to die. Those are unbelievers. You must remember James and John. They
have
been following the Lord. And then they are privileged like other people have privileges. They have been sent out to preach two by two. To heal the sick and to cast out devils. And then one day, Jesus took Peter, James, and John to the Mount of Transfiguration. And
before
the glory of the coming king, when they came back, then something began to walk inside them. Something began to whisper to them. Something began to counsel them inside. Something began to tell them, "Do you see that glory on that mountain? Don't you want it? Do you want Peter to get it before you? Do you want Matthew to know about it before you? Do you want Jesus to take decision and put somebody here and put somebody there before you get there? So in Mark chapter 10, these are good disciples. These converted people. These disciples of the Lord. These people who are visited the Mount of Transfiguration. In Mark chapter 10 and verse 35. And John, the sons of Zebedee, they come unto him saying, Master, we would that thou shouldest do for us whatsoever we shall desire.
Jacob ati Janu, awon mo se bere si wa sodo re wi pe oluko ni awon fe ki won ke se ohun ko te ba bere lowo re fun wa.
You see the method here.
Therefore,
the people use. It
won't
be very clear at the beginning. They say, will you do for us whatsoever we shall desire? And he said unto them, what would ye that I should do for you? He said unto him, grant unto us that we may sit one on thy right hand, the other on thy left hand, in thy glory. Well, you know how Jesus answered there. It was a manifestation of self. I pray in you and in me, it will be crucified. You see, this is what many people do not realize. Very, very dangerous for you to be successful. Very, very dangerous for me to be the pastor in a place like this. When other people come, even those newspaper people, they say, this church is like, this church is like, what's the secret of your success? I always tell them I'm not successful, it is the work of God.
Not
the pastors, they come to me. Oh, they say, how can our church be as large as your church? You say you are successful. When you want to drive a man to hell, make his head to swell up. When you want a man to fall from the pinnacle, show him how great he is, how high he is, how lifted up he is. So those pastors, they come, they say, this is a large church. What's the secret? I don't know any secret. All I want to know is that all those people, everyone will get to heaven one by one, and I will get to heaven as an individual. They say, isn't it wonderful those blind eyes are opening? I said, it's wonderful for them. Not for me. Because if that thing gets into my head, I will be hearing of heaven. I will not be able to get there. You pray for me that self will never come up. And you pray for yourself that self will never come
off.
When they tell me that somebody left Deeper Life, now he has a larger church than Deeper Life. They want me to be jealous. They want me to say, no, he's not preaching right. No, he's a wicked man. No, he's a backslider. And they want me to lose my own. So I say, if you have seen them, you are the one that went there, that saw what is there. Don't come and trouble me here. Let me stay with the little thing I'm doing. Don't let me miss the land of Canaan.
lọ́sọ rárá ìwàsí èké ló wà rárá kò lè rí bó ṣe bẹ́ẹ̀ sẹ́sọ yẹn máa máa sọ fún ẹ máa ní ẹwà ẹ̀yin lẹ dán tẹ rí wọ́n fẹ́ kí n pàdánù ìjọba ọ̀run ni èmi ò ní pàdánù Kénání yẹn mo fẹ́ débẹ̀.
I pray God will help you.
Àdúrà mi ni Bọ́lá wọ́n ràn mí lọ́wọ́.
Every time they want self to rise up again, you will knock that thing with the hammer of the word of God and blow up the head of self, and self will never be in our lives in Jesus' name.
Bó nígbàkúgbà tí àfẹ́mi àfẹ́mi bá fẹ́ rúra sókè nínú yín, ẹ mú òlù ńlá, ẹ sì ti fẹ́ orí rẹ̀ pátápátá kò ní lè gbéra mọ́ lórúkọ Jésù.
There is a crushing of the self life.
Mo ní fí fẹ́ ìgbáyé àfẹ́mi
tí kí máa wà. And there is cross bearing in everyday life.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ sì ni gbígbà ìgbélé ìbúlójoojúmọ́ ń bẹ.
Jesus said, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and bear his cross daily and follow me.
Jésù Kristì wí pé bí ẹnikẹ́ni bá fẹ́ ṣe ọmọ ẹ̀yìn mi, jẹ́ kó gbà ìgbélé ìbú rẹ̀ lójoojúmọ́ kó sì máa tàn mí lẹ́yìn.
Then I spoke about captivity to the law.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni mo sọ nípa dídí ara ẹni sísọ ara ẹni ní ìjọba
olúwa. You are a captive of the law.
Rí pé o ti di ẹni tí olúwa ti
gbà. You do not belong to yourself.
O kì í ṣe ti ara rẹ mọ́.
You cannot dress the way you want.
O lè máa wọṣọ bó ṣe ń fẹ́ mọ́.
You know some people they come in here.
Ẹ mọ̀ àwọn ẹlòmíràn máa ń wọlé wa.
I say I like that deeper life.
Wá ni mo fẹ́ ràn deeper life.
But I cannot stay there.
Ṣùgbọ́n mi ò lè dúró síbẹ̀.
Because there is too much regulation.
Nítorí pé àwọn òfin wọ́n ti pọ̀ jù.
Don't drink this one.
Ẹ mọ mú eléyìí
o. Don't go to this other place.
Wọ́n lọ síbi báyìí
o. Don't wear this one.
Má wọ eléyìí
o. Don't watch this one.
Má wọ eléyìí o.
Don't see this one.
Má ṣe rí eléyìí o.
I want to enjoy my liberty.
Mo fẹ́ gbádùn òmìnira tí mo ní.
It is that liberty that destroys a person and takes him away from heaven.
Òmìnira ẹ̀ nípa ẹlòmíràn ọ̀run tó sì mú kúrò níjọba ọ̀run.
We must be captives to the law.
A gbọ́dọ̀ jẹ́ ní ìgbèkùn
sí Olúwa. You are not your own anymore.
O kì í ṣe ti ara rẹ mọ́.
You cannot just go anywhere you want.
O kàn lè máa lọ́bikíbi
tó bá fẹ́. I just do anything that you want.
O kàn máa ṣe nǹkan tó bá wù ọ́.
The Lord has taken you. The Lord has captured you. I pray you will never escape from the hand of the law.
Olúwa ti gbà ọ́. Olúwa ti mú ọ. Àdúrà mi ni pé òní yọ bọ́mọ Olúwa lọ́wọ́ lórúkọ Jésù.
If you escape from the hand of the Lord, you have gone.
Torí pé tọ́lù ẹ̀bẹ́ yọ bárakú lọ́wọ́ Olúwa, Olúwa ti lọ nìyẹn.
All those people that are saying, I have escaped.
Gbogbo àwọn ẹ̀tọ́ jẹ́ pé mo ti bọ́, mo ti bọ́.
I am not under captivity anymore.
Mi ò sí lábẹ́ àjàgà kankan.
I am not in any cage anymore.
Mi ò sí nínú ogun
ìṣubú mọ́. I am free now.
Mo ti dominira báyìí.
I pray for you that you will never be free from the Lord.
Àdúrà mi ni pé o ò ní dominira kúrò lọ́wọ́ Olúwa.
You will never escape from the hand of the Lord.
O ò ní bọ́ kúrò lọ́wọ́ Olúwa.
If you escape from his hand, how do you want to get to heaven?
Tó o bá bọ́ kúrò lọ́wọ́ rẹ̀, bọ́ọ̀ lọ sí
kájọ́ rẹ̀. He is no more controlling you. How do you want to get to heaven?
Tó o bá yẹ pọ̀ kọ́ni ìṣàkóso rẹ̀, bọ́ọ̀ lọ sí kájọ́ rẹ̀.
His word is no more controlling your life. How do you want to get to heaven?
Tó o bá yẹ pọ̀ rẹ̀ kọ́ ló ń ṣàkóso ayé rẹ̀, bọ́ọ̀ lọ sí kájọ́ rẹ̀.
It is when you remain a captive of the Lord.
Nígbà tó o bá wà ní ẹrú Olúwa.
A servant of the Lord.
Tó o jẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ Olúwa.
Under the lordship and control of the Lord.
Lábẹ́ jíjẹ Olúwa àti àkóso Olúwa.
That he will take you home to glory.
Ìgbà náà nìkan ni ó mọ wọn ní olú ògo lọ.
In 1 Corinthians chapter 6.
Nínú Kọ́rìntì kìíní orí kẹfà.
Verses 19 and 20.
Ẹsẹ̀ kọkàndínlọ́gbọ̀n àtẹ̀sẹ̀gbọ̀n.
Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own?
Tàbí ẹ̀yin kò mọ̀ pé ara yín ni tẹ́ẹ̀pìlì ẹ̀mí mímọ́ tí ń bẹ nínú yín tẹ̀yí ti gbà lọ́wọ́ Ọlọ́run ẹ̀yin kì í sì ṣe ti ara
yín. For ye are bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God.
Nítorí a ti rà yín ní iye kan, nítorí náà ẹ̀yin Ọlọ́run lọ́gọ nínú ara yín àti nínú ẹ̀mí tí ń ṣe ti Ọlọ́run.
When self is totally destroyed and removed from our lives.
Nígbà tí a bá ti pa ẹ̀mí àfẹ́mi àfẹ́mi kúrò ní ayé ọ̀tá tí mo kúrò.
We will not struggle with the Lord anymore.
A ní máa bọ́ Olúwa jìjà dì mọ́.
We will be absolutely yielded, absolutely surrendered unto the Lord.
A ó yọ̀ǹda ara wa, a ó fi ara wa sílẹ̀ pátápátá fún Olúwa.
And now point number 3.
Kókó kẹta báyìí o.
Consecration for sanctification.
Ìyára ẹni sọ́tọ̀ fún ìsọdi mímọ́.
You know sanctification is a real thing.
A mọ̀ pé nǹkan tó dájú ni ìsọdi
mímọ́. It's a real experience.
Ìrírí tó dájú ni.
And it is a work of the grace of God in our hearts and lives.
Iṣẹ́ rí ọ̀fẹ́ Ọlọ́run ló sì jẹ́ nínú ọkàn wa àti nínú ayé wa.
In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5.
Nínú Tẹ̀sánlẹ́mẹ́ka kìíní orí karùn-ún.
Verse 23.
Ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlélógún.
And the very God of peace sanctify you wholly.
And I pray,
God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Faithful is he that calleth you, who also will do it. Very briefly, there are three things. Number one, cleansing for the saved. Christ-likeness of the sanctified. Number three, covenant with the sanctified. When you are born again, you are cleansed. And ye are clean through the word which has spoken unto you.
Friend,
there is a cleansing now. Even after you are saved, that makes you whiter, much whiter than snow. In Psalm 51 and in verse 7, touch me with hyssop and I shall be clean. That's one thing. Wash me now and I shall be whiter than snow. That's another thing. And then when you allow the Lord,
as you
desire this sanctification, as you say, Lord, this is what I want. Except you do this for me, I will not go. I want it, I desire it, I love it. I want the life of Enoch to be reproduced in me. That same purity that you gave unto Joseph, he hated sin, even when nobody was there, and there was a woman making herself chief, saying, come and do this, come and do this, and he ran away. That kind of purity give unto me.
There is a desire within you.
And then there is a consecration.
You are saying, Lord, I surrender.
I submit myself. I yield myself unto you. I want you to work on me. If the doctor is making an operation on a person, if that person is not knocked up and is struggling with that doctor, will that operation be properly performed? The answer is no. You yield to the hand of the Lord, like the patient yields to the hand of the surgeon that is performing the operation. And then there is prayer. You pray with all your heart. You know this thing is greater than healing. It's greater than deliverance. It's greater than money. It's greater than material things. With the seriousness it takes, you will pray to the Lord. Because this is the thing that will grant you an entrance into heaven.
Okay?
You pray with faith. Because the Bible says, giving them inheritance among them that are sanctified by faith.
Which means faith is very important.
If we are going to get that sanctification, there is a strong desire. There is the consecration. There is the prayer. And there is the faith. When it happens, what does it bring? There is a renewed cleansing. That makes you whiter than snow. There is also Christ-likeness. That you become so Christ-like. You think the way he thinks. You plan the way he plans. You're obedient to the Father the way he's obedient to the Father. You are in submission to the revelation of God the way he was. You submit yourself completely unto his will. You do all the things that are always pleasing unto him.
gbogbo nkan to wu nigba gbogbo.
You never have any argument or disagreement with Almighty God.
O ni ma ba Olorun jize ariyanjiyan
tabi ko ma gbogbo nkan to be. There is Christ likeness in your life.
Did that be Christian wa nu re.
Then God makes a covenant for the sanctified.
Leyin na Olorun se ibajemu pelu eta so
bi. Told in Hebrews chapter 8 and in verse 10.
Ase fun anu we beru.
About that covenant you will make with the people that are sanctified. He repeats that same covenant in chapter 10 of Hebrews verse 16. Hebrews chapter 10 verse 16. This is a covenant that I will make with them after those days, says the Lord. I will put my laws into their hearts, and in their mind will I write them.
Lẹ́yìn ọjọ́ wọn ni ni Olúwa wí. Èmi ò fi òfin mi sí wọn lé ọkàn. Inú wọn pẹ̀lú ni èmi ò sì kọ́ wọn.
He will write his law in your heart.
Yóò kọ òfin rẹ̀ sínú ọkàn rẹ̀.
And you will know more say I didn't know.
Òṣùwà ni máa sọ pé wọn ò mọ ni.
I didn't know.
Wọn ò mọ ni.
You will know it, you will write it inside your heart.
Wàá mọ̀ ọ́ pé yóò kọ́ sínú ọkàn rẹ̀.
It's perfect law.
Ìfẹ́ rẹ̀
pípé. It's holy will. It's great statutes.
Ọ̀fin rẹ̀ pípé.
The great principles of his law.
Àwọn ìlànà ìfẹ́ rẹ̀
pípé. The right things on the heart of the sanctified believer.
Yóò kọ́ sínú ọkàn ẹni tí onígbàgbọ́ tá a sọ di mímọ́.
Can God do it today?
Ọlọ́run àlẹ́ ṣẹ́ lónìí bí.
I said can God do it today?
Ó ní ṣe Ọlọ́run lè ṣe lónìí.
If we will pray.
Bí àwọn bá lè gbàdúrà.
Not the kind of prayer we pray whenever we listen to a message on heaven, on sanctification, on rapture. Not that kind of prayer, because we're not serious when we pray for this serious important thing.
Mo máa ń rú àwọn àdúrà míì tá a máa ń gbà nígbà tá a bá ń sọ nípa ọ̀run ìsọdínmọ́ tàbí ìgbàsókè kì í ṣe rú àdúrà bẹ́ẹ̀ ṣùgbọ́n ń gbà tá a bá ń gbàdúrà fún nǹkan tó ṣe pàtàkì bí eléyìí.
See the believers of today when they are praying for holiness and deliverance. Sorry, for healing and deliverance. When we are praying to chase away the devil and chase away witches and wizards, see how believers pray.
Sanctification
now. And the crucifixion of self. See how we pray that even heaven understands that these people, they don't want to get to heaven. But we are different here. Our goal is heaven. Because if after all this worship, after all this preaching, after all the things we have done, if we don't get there eventually, what's the gain?
Tọ́ba wa jẹ́ pé lẹ́yìn gbogbo ìsìn, lẹ́yìn gbogbo àkókò tá a fi sílẹ̀ tá a fi ń gbọ́ gbogbo ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run tá a bá wá dọ̀hún.
And you have been here during this retreat. Everything that you have heard. All the testimonies you have heard. All the clapping we have done. If we don't get over there on the final day. And we fail the final test. You better get and they say, where is your sanctification? See your life. See self, how self destroyed your life. And then Jesus looks at you and he points to the left hand side and said, you can't enter here without holiness. You can't get in here without sanctification. And then he points to the other side. That time you will cry. That time you will ask, is there another chance? Esau prayed, but it was too late. At the time he should have been serious about the birthright. He wasn't serious about it. Jacob had taken it. Jacob had entered in. Will you make heaven? Will you make heaven? Why don't you rise up? See self in our lives. See how ugly our lives are. See pride in our lives. See bragging in our lives. See the search for success in our lives. Marriage only in our lives. Only money. We are crying for in our lives. Finality is there. Godliness is there. Bragging is there. Pride is there. himself is there. It's in pastors. It is in the pastors of churches. It is in leaders of churches. No holiness. No humility. No crushing of the self-life. No Christ-likeness. There is no conformity to the image of God in our lives. There is no holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Pentecostal churches are multiplying, but there is no holiness. New ministries are multiplying, but there is no holiness. They're multiplying new fellowship, new churches, and new ministries with night vigil, with fasting, with everything, and there is no holiness. Many people are praying for miracle, but there is no holiness. Many people are speaking in tongues, but there is no holiness. There are many people that are running here and there, but there is no holiness. We attend retreat in deeper life, we attend convention in another place, we attend camp meeting in another place, we run from place to place looking for something, but there is no holiness. Holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Do I have it as a preacher? Do I have it as a pastor? Success is not holiness. Ability to preach is not holiness. Maybe I can pray for the sick, that's not holiness. Maybe I'm a mighty prayer warrior member, that's not holiness. Maybe I can prophesy, that's not holiness. Maybe I can bring water out of the rock, that's not holiness. Maybe I can multiply the food for 5,000 to eat, that's not holiness. Maybe I can dream to have a wife, that's not holiness. Maybe I can begin a new church, that's not holiness. Maybe I can endure to fast for 21 days. That's not holiness. However, the self in your life, you want to make a name. You want to build a strong tower. You want to be made a judge in Israel. You want to be made a counselor of the people. You want to be elected and voted for. Holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Is your heart clean? Is my heart clean? Is your heart right with God? Is my heart right with God? Do I want to go to heaven? Am I just looking for the cheap place of men down here? A man can be effective, a woman can be effective. I say, what kind of church? But is that holiness? A man can be successful in business. Is that holiness? A man can have prosperity. Is that holiness? A man can get married in 1 month. I dream. Is that holiness? A man may go to a particular place, they give him water to drink, and they give him olive oil to rub himself and have a child. Is that holiness? A man can go to a new church, they make him a bishop, they make him a bishop, they make him apostle. Is that holiness?
mi je abo mi ki won si je bishop ki won si je olori bishop ije iwo mi mani ye bi.
A man may be a backslider here, he goes to a new church and they make him a walker there. Is that holiness? A man may be under discipline here and then he runs to another church and they make him apostle. Is that holiness? Without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. Without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. The Lord is coming. The end is very near. Only the people that are sanctified. Only the people that are holy. Only the people that are humble. Only the people that are cross-self. Only the people that can deny self. Only the people that can bear their cross. Only the people that are following the Lord. Only the people that are conformed to Christ. Only the people that have covenant with the Lord. Only the people whose hearts are circumcised. Only the people that are humble to the ground. Only the people that are sincere. Only the people that are faithful. Only the people that are steadfast in the way of the Lord. Only the people that are walking in the way of holiness. In the way of holiness. In the way of holiness. Only the people that are following the old path. Only those people will make heaven at last. People will make heaven at last. Where will you be when the trumpet shall sound? Where will you be when the trumpet shall sound? Where will you be when the trumpet shall sound? Will you be in heaven? 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 It takes more than working a miracle. It takes more than establishing a church. It takes more than starting a new ministry. Heaven is our goal. Don't let success take heaven from you. Don't let ability to preach take heaven from you. Don't let successful prayer warrior membership take heaven from you. If your right hand causes you to offend, cut it off. If your right eye makes you to offend, pluck it out. Heaven is our goal. Heaven is our goal. Heaven is our goal. Are you going to a church where they are deceiving you? Where pride is multiplying. Where worldliness is multiplying. Gossip is multiplying. Are you going to a church where they have not crucified self? Where self is given liberty. And you say, I'm now free to do what I want. I'm not under a cage. I'm not under any captivity. I'm not under control of anybody anymore. That liberty will ruin your life and take you to hell. Come under the yoke of the Lord. Take my yoke upon you. Take my yoke upon you. Take my yoke upon you. Tell the Lord, O Lord, don't let me escape out of your hands. If you escape out of the hand of the Lord, you escape into hell. Cleanse me. Crush the self out of my life. The Lord, I give myself unto you. Make me your captive. Make me your captive. Sanctify me. Purify me. Purge me completely. Make me whiter than snow. Separate me from sin and separate sin from me. Separate me unto the Lord. I give myself completely afresh unto you. be with me, Lord.
Olúwa pẹ̀lú mi.
Abide in me.
Wà á máa gbé nínú mi.
Help me so I will not perish.
Wọ́n ràn mí lọ́wọ́ kí má bàa ṣègbè.
My friends have gone back to the world. Keep me, O Lord, in the Lord.
Àwọn ọ̀rẹ́ mi ti padà sínú ayé Olúwa wá parí mẹ́nu rẹ̀.
Those who preach the gospel to me before they have gone back into the world, O Lord, keep me near unto you.
Àwọn tó wà sí fún mi wọ́n ti padà kúrò lẹ́yìn Olúwa.
Jesus, keep me near the cross. Jesus, keep me near the cross. Turn my eyes away from the world. Turn my eyes away from what they call success. Turn my eyes away from the sin that is pulling them, dragging them down. My eyes on the Lord. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith.
Say with the Lord.
It will not be long. The trumpet shall sound. The dead in Christ shall rise. And we which are alive and
remain
unto the coming of the Lord,
we
shall be caught up to be with them together in the air.
So shall
we ever be with the Lord. And he
will
cast this hope in him, being Christ himself, even as he is pure, partaking of an eye in the last strong. For the trumpet shall sound, and we'll hear the voice of the archangel, and then we will put on incorruption. Then we shall all be changed. My father's house are many mansions. If it were not, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. Take you unto myself, so that where I am, there ye may be also. How are you going to get there? Lord, who shall dwell in thy holy hill? Who shall be in the mouth of the Lord? They that have clean hands and a pure heart. They shall not lift up their hearts unto vanity. They that walk uprightly, that will not have any partnership with the wicked people. If you say the wicked, the vile people, they are contemned. They are the people that swear to their hearts and they will never change. They are the people that will not meddle with the people that are given to change. And the righteous man is the one that is holding on to his way. And he says, Lord, bind me to the cross. Tie me to the cross. Bind me to the altar. I will never leave the Lord. I will never leave the Lord. I will never leave the Lord. Until they will come. Until he will come and take me to my home. I will be with him, I will be with him, I will be with him till then and forevermore. Tell the Lord, so I will not miss the rapture, the glorious scene of that day. For without holiness, no man shall see the Lord.